Dear students, welcome to my YouTube channel on Engineering Graphics subject. In this video, we'll see about the solution for Anna University January 2018 Forenoon question paper. I'm Dr.M.Senthil Kumar. We'll see the answers for all the 10 questions. Now, the first question 1A. A circle of diameter 50 mm rolls along the inside of another circle of diameter 200 mm without slipping. Draw the path traced by a point on the smaller circle. Draw a tangent and normal at a point on the curve. Okay, now you have to draw a bigger arc first with a diameter of 200 mm or the radius of 100 mm. Okay, so this is the question. Draw arc AB, right? Its radius is equal to 100 mm. But for that arc AB, you should find out the angle. Okay, before finding out the angle, I'll tell you what should be the length, arc length of AB. The arc length of AB must be equal to the circumference of the smaller circle. The diameter for the smaller circle is 50. So the circumference of this smaller circle is pi d, pi 50. Okay, so the arc length AB must be equal to the circumference of the smaller circle, pi 50. So okay, that is one way. Then to find out the angle for this arc AB, there is a formula. Theta is equal to small r by capital R into 360, where small r equal to radius of the smaller circle, capital R is equal to radius of the bigger circle. So 25 by 100 into 360, that is equal to 90. So draw arc whose included angle is 90 degree. Okay, so you have completed it. Then divide the arc AB into 12 parts and name it as 1, 2, 3 and so on. The next step is draw from A on this line, mark O, which is 25, that is the radius of the smaller circle. Then with O as center, draw the circle. 25 mm as radius, draw the circle. Since you divided the arc AB into 12, divide this circle also into 12 and name it as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash and so on. The next step, with this point as center, draw arcs passing through the points 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash as well as the center of the circle O, smaller circle O, 4 dash, 5 dash and 6 dash. Okay, you have drawn the arc. Then the arc which you have drawn through the center of the smaller circle, you know, divide that arc also into 12 parts and name it as O1, O2, O3, O4 and so on. So you have completed all the standard procedures. Now we'll go for getting the points for this path traced by a point on the smaller circle. The path traced by a point on the smaller circle is nothing but a cycloid. More precisely, it is a hypocycloid. Initially, we are going to trace the point, this particular point. This A at present, the A is common for both the start of the bigger arc and this circle. So we'll be tracing that point. So initially the point is here. Say after 1/12 of rotation, initially the 1 dash, there is a gap between 1 dash and 1. After 1/12 of rotation, the 1 dash will be touching, okay, coinciding with the point 1 here. The point 1 here. If that is the case, this point will be moved through this distance, the gap between 1 dash and 1 now. Right? So how to get it? For that, the standard procedure is with O1 as center, set the compass to 25, that is radius of the smaller circle. With O1 as center, 25, always 25 as radius, cut arc on this arc passing through 1 dash. So this is the point for 1-1. Similarly, for 2-1, with O2 as center, 25 as radius, cut arc on the arc passing through 2 dash. Follow the same, similar kind of procedure for the other points, 3-1. 4-1, 5-1, 6-1 and so on. Okay, till it reaches the point B after one full rotation of the smaller circle. Then join all the cutting points by freehand in a single stroke. That is the path traced by a point on the smaller circle, which is nothing but hypocycloid. So one part is over. The other part is to draw a tangent and normal at a point on the curve. Okay, for this, the procedure is mark point P somewhere on this curve. Point P is marked. The next step is the compass is already set at a distance of 25 mm, right? With P as center, P as center, 25 as radius, cut arc on the arc passing through the center, center of the small circle O. Get Q. Then draw line joining Q and this point, the center of the bigger arc AB. Then extend it till it cuts the arc AB. Mark that point as R. Now draw line joining RP, that is a normal at the point P. Then using minute drop scale, if you draw a line perpendicular to RP, that is nothing but the line ST, which is the required tangent. Okay, this is the answer. Okay, in all the, for all the 10 problems, if you have any doubt, pause the video, see the question and see the drawing, match it, view it carefully, you will get to know, you will understand about the solution for all the problems. We'll see the next problem. 1B, make freehand sketches of front, top and left side view of the object shown in the figure. So this is the object shown in the question paper. Okay. For this, I need not explain much about this one, because you know the standard procedure of getting the three different orthographic views, top view, front view and side view, for the given isometric view or pictorial view, right? This is the view direction for the front. So this is the area for the front. This is the area for the top, the left side view. This is the area for the left side view. Okay. So this is the question. This is the three-dimensional model. This is the front view, top view and the left side view. In as per the first angle projection, the left side view will come to the right of the front view. Okay. Pause the video. As I said earlier, pause the video. Then see the question and the solid model and match these with the three different orthographic views. You will understand the solution for this particular question. Okay. Now we'll move to the next question, 2A. A straight line ST has its end S 10 mm in front of VP and nearer to it. The midpoint M of the line is 50 mm in front of VP and 40 mm above HP. The front and top views measure 100 mm and 120 mm respectively. Draw the projection of the line. Also find its true length and true inclination with the reference planes. It's a midpoint problem. So this is the question. Okay, I'll tell you the answer in step by step. After drawing XY line, you see carefully the one end S is 10 mm in front of VP. Draw a locus, this locus, which is 10 mm in front of VP. Then the next step is, you can easily mark the midpoint M, M dash and M, which is 50 in front. M is 50 in front, M dash is 40 above. So somewhere on this, maybe at the middle of the XY line, draw a vertical line on it, mark M dash, which is 40 above XY, 40 above HP and 50 in front of VP, 50 below XY. M dash and M is marked. Okay. Then now you marked M dash M and the locus for the in top view side. So then you can mark the S. Okay, to start with, S you cannot mark now. Let me tell you how to mark S now. In you see what is the top view length. The front view length is 100, the top view length is 120. So top view length is 120. That means from the midpoint, the top view line, length of the top view line must be 120. From the midpoint, S must be half of 120. The distance between M and S must be 120 divided by 2, 60. So set the compass to 60 with M as center, cut arc on this locus, you will get S. Once you get a S, draw line joining M, S and extend and mark T, which is again 60 away, 120 by 2. Away from this side. So ST is the final top view that you obtained first now. The next step, draw projector through S and T. So this is the projector through T, this is the projector through S. Now you see the question. Now the front view measures 100 mm. Okay, from the point of view of midpoint, 100 by 2, 50, 50 this way, 50 that way. Set the compass to 50. Okay. With M dash as center, cut arc on this projector, you get A dash, S dash. and cut arc on this projector passing through T, you can get T dash. Then draw line joining S dash T dash, thereby you will be getting the front view straight away. Okay, so you have directly obtained top view and front view from the given data. Now we will see how to get the preliminary front view. From the preliminary front view, you have to get the true values, true length, theta, pi. We'll start with the top view side. Now the ST line is inclined to XY. You rotate and make it parallel. Thereby S1, T1, lengthwise it is equal to ST, but it is parallel to XY. If it is parallel to XY, this top view is parallel to XY, the corresponding front view is called the preliminary front view. So draw projector from T1 through S1, thereby you can get S1 dash and T1 dash there. Draw line joining S1 dash and T1 dash, that is a preliminary front view that will show true length and true angle theta. So measure the true length, it is 128. So true length, you write it separately also. True length is equal to 128 mm. Measure the angle theta equal to 20 degrees. Similarly, in the front view side, rotate and make it parallel the front view. So then you will be getting S2 dash T2 dash. So this is parallel to XY. So the corresponding other view, the corresponding top view is called preliminary top view, that shows again true length and true angle pi. Draw projectors, okay, thereby obtain S2 there, T2 here. Draw line joining S2, T2 and measure the length, it must be equal to 128. Measure the angle, it is 39 degrees. Mark it here as well as separately also. So that completes the problem here. We'll see the next problem, 2B. A hexagonal plate of side 20 mm rests on the HP on one of its sides inclined at 45 degrees to VP. The surface of the plate makes an angle of 30 degrees with the HP. Draw the front and top view of the plane. You see it is a hexagonal plate of side 20. One side is on the HP. Okay, even after tilting, both with respect to VP and with respect to HP. Now, I'll be taking this first and this next. That is 30 degrees with HP first and 45 degrees with respect to VP next. So this is a question. The first step, draw the initial top view. In top view, draw the hexagon such that one side or two sides may be AF as well as DC perpendicular to XY or perpendicular to VP. Okay, draw the corresponding front view, A dash, B dash, C dash. Okay, then I have to tilt this one with respect to HP first now. Okay, even though this value has been given in at the later part, this will be I'm considering first. Okay, so tilt this front view at an incline at an angle of 30 degrees with respect to HP. So it has been tilted. Okay, so you see that it is seen as a point here. It is actually not a point, it is a side, A dash F dash, AF or A dash F dash. So it is on XY, that means that side or edge is in HP. Okay, draw projectors, draw horizontal lines, you can complete the second top view. Then take this second top view, you have to tilt such that this edge is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Okay, so with respect to that, you complete the third and final top view. Okay, so that is the final top view. Then how to get the final front view? As usual, draw projectors, draw horizontal lines, you will be getting all the points. You see, draw and connect all the points in proper sequence using scale, that completes the problem. This is the final front view. You see, wherein the edge, the side AF is on XY, that means is on the ground or on rest on HP. Okay, so this is the answer. Again, if you have any doubt, as I said earlier, pause the video, continue to play the video, pause the video, see the question and see the answer, read the question and see the answer, you will understand easily. We'll see the next problem, 3A. A hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm and axis length 60 mm rests on HP on one of its base edges with its axis inclined at 60 degrees to HP and parallel to VP. So if the axis is parallel to VP, that means the axis is parallel to VB and inclined at an angle of 60 degrees to HP. If the axis is inclined at 60 degrees to HP, the base is, must be inclined at 90 minus 60, 30 degrees. Okay, so you have to tilt the solid such that initially the base is inclined at 90 minus 60, 30 degrees, but don't show that angle, show the inclination of axis as 60. So this is the question. For this, draw the hexagon such that the two sides FA and DC perpendicular to VP or perpendicular to XY. Okay, draw the corresponding the front view. Now you have to tilt this front view such that the base is inclined at 30. Okay, that means the base and the axis are mutually perpendicular. So then axis is inclined at 90 minus 30 is 60. Okay, after drawing this line with respect to this line, you complete the final front view. To get the final top view, draw projectors and draw horizontal lines. To get this view, the observer has to see this from this end. For this observer, the top face is completely visible, the bottom base, half of it is visible, the remaining half is not visible. The next point is, for this observer, this, there are two points here, these the lines connecting those two points are hidden. Okay, so these two points are far off points, the lines connecting this way, this side 3, but one is common for both the points. So totally 5 edges are not visible, 5 edges are hidden, all other edges are visible. Okay, so that completes the problem. We'll see the next question. Question number 3b. A pentagonal pyramid of base edge 25 mm and axis length 60 mm rests on one base side on HP such that the highest base corner is 20 mm above HP. Its axis is parallel to VP. Draw its top view and front view. Here, in general, the tilting angle will be given. Here, instead of giving the tilting angle, they have given after tilting, the other corner or the opposite corner is at a height of 20 mm above HP. That is how it has been given. Okay, we'll see the problem. So this is the question. Okay, now draw the top view first, such that top view is a pentagon, such that one base edge CD is perpendicular to XY, perpendicular to VP. Okay, then it is a pyramid. So you have to show the apex even in front view. By drawing two median lines, you can get the apex O. Then draw line joining all the five corners. That those are the slant edges, right? Then with respect to this, get the corresponding front view. Now you have to tilt this such that base edge C dash D dash is on the ground, the opposite corner A dash is at a height of 20 mm from HP, from the XY line. For that, the step is, first you draw a locus which is 20 above XY, above HP. Then somewhere on XY, mark C dash, C1 dash, then set the compass to C dash, A dash in the initial front view. With that as radius, C1 dash as center, cut arc on this locus which is 20 above. Thereby you will be getting A1 dash, right? Now you draw line joining A1 dash, C1 dash, that is a base in final front view. With respect to this, complete the entire final front view, right? Then draw projectors and horizontal lines, thereby you will be getting the points for the final top view. To get this view, observer has to see this from this end. For this observer, this point, it is not a point actually, it is an edge, okay, CD, right? Two points are, that edge is hidden, okay? All other edges are visible, okay? So that is the answer for this question 3b. We'll see next question. 4a, a right circular cone of base diameter 50 mm and axis length 60 mm rests on its base on HP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to HP and inclined at 60 degrees to VP. The shortest distance between the cutting plane and top view of the axis is 8 mm. Draw the top view, sectional front view and the true shape of the section. So first you draw the projection of a solid, then introduce the section plane. The section plane is seen as a line in top view. So you have to introduce the section plane in top view here, right? So this is the question. Draw the circle, then divide the circle into 12 parts, show all the 12 generators, the center point is apex O, then draw the corresponding front view. Then read the problem. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to HP. That means it is seen as a line in top view. So before introducing the cutting plane, first of all, you read the problem again. The shortest distance between the cutting plane and the top view of the axis is 8 mm. So draw a 8 mm radius circle with O as center in top view, or 8 circle. Then set the minute after scale inclined at an angle 60 degrees. So tangent to this R8 circle, draw that 60 degree line. So this is the line. It cuts the generator 1, generator 2, generator 3, 4, 5 and the base. So 5 plus 2. There are 7 cutting points. Keep track on all the 7 cutting points, even for getting the points in the sectional in the front view. Thereby you can complete the sectional front view. And also the sectional, the true shape of the section. For the true shape of the section, parallel to this cutting plane 17 line, draw x1 y1 reference line. With respect to that, draw lines perpendicular to x1 y1. On it, you have to get the points 11, 21, 31, and so on. For example, to get the 21 here, okay, get the height of 2 dash this distance from xy. The height of 2 dash in front of you from xy, that is the distance. With the intercept this point on x1 y1 as center, okay, cut arc and get 0.21. Follow the similar procedure for 3 4 5 6. Of course 1 and 7 are on the base, that means on x1 y1 itself. Okay, complete the profile and hatch both the sectional front view area as well as the true shape of the section. This is the answer. We'll see the next problem. 4b. Hexagonal pyramid of base side 25 mm and altitude 50 mm is resting vertically on its base on the ground with two of the sides of the base perpendicular to the VP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degrees to HP. The plane bisects the axis of the pyramid. Draw the development of lateral surface of the pyramid. Now you see the problem. It is a development problem. It is the given solid is a hexagonal pyramid. If it is a pyramid, you have to follow a radial line method. If it is a prism, you have to follow a parallel line method. Since it is a hexagonal pyramid, you have to follow the radial line method. So draw the projection first with the given data. I need not explain much about the projection of solid part and the section part also. It is self-explanatory. Otherwise, pause the video, see the read the question, see the diagram carefully. You will get to know the details. The cutting plane cuts all the 6 slant edges. 1, 2, 3, 4 on back of 3, 5 dash is on back of 2 dash, 6 dash is at the back of 1 dash. Okay. To draw the development, you see the which slant edge in front of you shows the true slant length. For that, the condition is, in top view, you see which slant edge is parallel to VP or parallel to XY. No slant edge is parallel to XY. So you have to make it parallel for getting the true slant length. So for example, I have considered 1A. 1A is inclined to XY now. I rotated and made it parallel to XY. Now OA1 is parallel to XY. That means the corresponding length line O dash A1 dash must show the true slant length. Right, so draw a projector from A1 and get A1 dash on XY. Draw line joining O dash A1 dash, that is the line that shows the true slant length. With this true slant length, that is why it is given. With the true slant length, you have to draw arc, then draw the full development. Okay, this is the radial line method, you know it already. Okay, I considered C as the start, because if you see the front view here, this is the least portion, this is the most portion. Okay, so you have to always start the point where you are seeing the you are having the least material, right? So 3c length is the least length. Okay, so C as the start, C D E F A B, then C. The next step, you have to get the cutting points 1 2 3 4 5 6 on to the development. For that, the procedure is transfer these points the cutting points onto TSL by drawing horizontal lines. So this is the O dash 11 dash is the distance for the cutting points 1 and 6. Okay, so 1, take this distance with the, using compass with O as center, mark 11 on OA, capital OA, mark 61 on capital OF. Similarly, for 2 and 5, take this distance with O as center, mark 21 and 51. This is the distance O dash and this point. Distance is the distance for the points 3 and 4. So 3 and 4. Okay, draw all these cutting points and darken only the portion remaining. The dark blue is the portion remaining, the light blue or the sky blue is the portion removed. Okay, so this is the answer for this. We see the next problem, 5a. Draw the isometric view of a frustum of a cone of height 30 mm, base diameter 34 mm, top diameter 20 mm, when it is centrally placed over a square slab of side 50 mm and thickness 10 mm. See, these kinds of problem is also combination of solid or setup of solid problem is a self learning problem only. Okay, so this is the question. You are asked to draw the isometric view, so you can directly take the values. You need not use the isometric scale. So it is self-explanatory. The rectangular slab you can easily draw. Then for the base of the for the frustum of a cone, the base diameter, for the base diameter you have to follow the four center method to draw the circle seen as an ellipse in isometric. Then from here center mark the height 30, that is the height of the frustum. With this center draw another rhombus, follow the four center method. Complete this, then show the tangent generators. These are the tangent generators. Okay, so this is the answer for this. If you have any clarification, again as I said, pause the video, refer the question and see the answer diagram carefully. Okay, you will understand very well. We'll see the last question, 5b. A rectangular prism 40 30 15 rest on the ground on one of its ends with one of the longest edges touching the PP and one of the longest edges touching the PP and the shortest edges receding to the left. The longest edge is on PP, 40 is on PP, and the shortest edge 15 mm edge is inclined at 40. The nearest vertical edge is 15 mm to the left of the station point, that is the central plane is to the left of the station point. On station point, the I point is 55 mm in front of PP and 30 mm above the ground. Draw the perspective prism. This is the question. Okay, first you see, read the first sentence. For that, before that, you draw a PP line first. With respect to the PP line, you have to draw the top view. So the longest edge is 40 seen as a point in top view. So this is the point, mark point. This mark this as B for example. Then you see the read the problem. The shortest edge among 40, 30, 15, 15 is the shortest. The 15 mm shortest edge is inclined at 40 degree. So this is the 15 mm line AB, which is inclined at 40 degree. So once you have drawn, then you can complete. Once you have drawn the shortest edge with respect to the given data, you can complete this rectangle. Show the dimension 15, 30. Mark the edges A, B, C, D. Okay. The next step is you have to draw the front view. For the front view, GP is the reference line. The standard procedure for maintaining the gap between the gap or the distance between the PP and GP is slightly more than the sum of the in front of you and above distance of the station point. So 55 plus 30, 85 plus 10 more, 95. Maintain at least 95 mm distance between PP and this GP. So draw a GP which is 95 mm below. Okay, with respect to GP line, draw a projector from all the top view points. With respect to that, complete the front view. Okay, I told you already in my previous videos. The point in the case of a perspective projection, we are following the first angle projection. Okay, we are following third angle projection perspective, not the first angle projection, right? If we say we are following the third angle projection perspective, means to get this front view, the observer to see this top view from the inner side. If you have to follow a first angle projection, then the procedure is to get this front view, observer to see this top view from the outer side. Now we will be following third angle projection to get this view, front view. The observer to see this top view from this inner side. For this inner side observer, point B is the nearest, point D is the farthest. So the vertical edge which is passing through D is hidden in front view. So D dash is here. That vertical edge passing through D dash is hidden. Okay, that is why I told you about the procedure for the third angle projection. The next step, as per the given data, this vertical line, green line, is a central plane which is 15 mm to the left. On it, mark top view of the station point 55 in front of PP, 55 in front of PP and 30 above GP. The next step is standard step. Join all the front top view points with S. Join all the front view points with S dash. This is S dash. This is S. I didn't mention here the smallest and smallest dash. This is small S and this is smallest dash. Okay, you have joined all the front view points here. Now you see one more point here. The station point, the observer I position is in between the top face and base of the solid. That means in perspective, the observer cannot see both the top face as well as the base. Both are hidden. That is another point. Then through the, you know very well that how to get the points in perspective as per the visual ray method. Okay, for example, to get the points A, okay, the vertical edge A, through this intercept on PP, draw a projector. It cuts the line joining S dash, A dash at A. So this is capital A and this is the A1 maybe, right, the vertical edge, right. Follow the similar procedure for the other remaining points. Join the boundary by thick continuous line type. I said the top face is also hidden, base is also hidden. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 edges are hidden. That is the answer. Okay. Now we have seen the solutions for all the 10 questions asked in Anna University January 2018 forenoon. Okay. Hope you understood and you got to know the solution for all the 10 problems. I hope that you did well in the examinations. My best wishes to all of you. Good luck.